Let me introduce a revolutionary concept to you guys. If someone puts you on a lock, and it hurts, tap out. Tap out right there. Don't scream, don't say all this nonsense. You can do all that, actually, but tap out. Does it make you feel like a bitch? I don't know. Or are you too dumb to know what that is? Or are your instincts so fucked up that when you actually get that lock, you don't do it? Well, maybe your instincts suck and so do you. And for guys that put these locks on the person, when they tap out, you let go. And even if they don't tap out, if they're really making a lot of noises and they're really in pain, you know, seemingly, just let go anyway, because your opponent may not be as intelligent as you are, and you have to account for that. I'm sick of seeing cases where, you know, two people play fighting and play wrestling, and maybe they're watching WrestleMania, I know, and someone is actually a kid and his uncle were watching WrestleMania 28. The kid puts on a sleeper hold. My uncle's freaking out at some point, and he's like telling the kid to stop, but no, the guy ends up, he dies from that simple-ass hold. That irritated me because I knew the comment section was going to be full of drivel. It's seen as a tragedy. It is a tragedy. But yeah, that really ticks me off when I see that. If someone puts you on a hold, and yeah, you have no way of getting out of it. At that point, you should find a way to, like, fuck that person up if they're not responding. And that kid was probably excited as hell because apparently they saw the Undertaker versus Triple H Hell in a Cell match. And I will admit that that match was exciting only because of the chair shots. The whole psychology of Shawn Michaels as a guest referee and the pedigree and the super kid. Nah, I don't really care about all that, but really, that's what happened. That annoys me. That truly gets on my case. And I've been in situations, like I know with my little bro, I put him on a lion tamer, which is a Boston crab that's elevated a little bit, and I put my knee on his back. I knew damn well that is a legit move that will legitimately hurt, no matter what. So when he started screaming, I let go right there. He was like, hey, why the hell would you put that move on? Like, why the hell didn't you tap out? I didn't ask him that because people in my family have a tendency to ask stupid questions because they're not as smart as me. They're not at all. At least this side of my family, on my mom's side, I regress to mean really hard because of her. Anyway. But I knew what to do. You see, he may not have been doing the right thing, but I did the right thing. And the same thing kind of happened a month or two earlier where I had him on a platter. I was going to make it fake, but I leaned back a little to do something else. I was preoccupied with something. He started reacting like, he started making noises like he was in some serious pain. I let go immediately because that's chivalry. And we need to start teaching that. Because boys will be boys. I hate the fact that kids are getting punished for doing something like cowboys and Indians or play fighting or doing stuff like that because the environment is so PC and feminized that they can't engage in behavior like that. Up the river in doses. But we also have to teach kids not to be monkeys. But to teach people how to be monkeys. Because I notice people that do engage in these activities, they don't do it with chivalry. They don't do it correctly. And that has to be enacted. If you have someone on a walk and you know that they're at your mercy, because that person doesn't know how to get out of the walk, it should be your responsibility to make sure that person doesn't get seriously hurt. It's that simple, guys. Yes, he said about this all the time. And I'm not going to be a hypocrite about it because I know how stuff like this works. But have a little common sense, have a little chivalry. Know that if you have a person in a position where you can do whatever you want with them, you're in control, exercise some responsibility to that person. It's not that hard. It actually takes less energy. And it gets you into less trouble. See, what if I was like that dumbass kid and my little bro was screaming and crying, but he didn't tap out? I don't want to like diss the kid or anything because he was really young and he didn't look like he was in the right side of the bell curve anyway. Like, dude, he was like one of those fat kids. So if I had him, let's say, on the plotter, and I kept him there, even though he was screaming just because he didn't tap out, or just because I was too excited, which I wasn't, what am I going to do? I'm going to break the guy's shoulder. That's dumb. I wouldn't want to do that. Especially since I know that my real bro plays in the basketball team. That'd be the dumbest thing I'd ever do. It, like, ruins chances of a lot of opportunities. So I'm not going to do that. And when I see that stuff like this happens all the time, I'm a little more merciful if it's a prepubescent person. But if you're at a high school level and stuff like this happens, you're a dork. And that is a personal pet peeve of mine because in terms of socializing in this fashion, I do enjoy activities like this. I do enjoy when guys can be guys. Like, sometimes I'm not feeling it, and there's consequences to that. That a person is a monkey, and they are usually monkeys. But come on, guys, have a little respect for the other person, because you know damn well when the bone snaps that they're not just going to be a piece of meat to you. That is Mr. Rocket 7, and suck my dick.